every year that we've done this project, it becomes more and more central to who we are as a company, and we enjoy the people we get to work with every year. The playwrights become members of our family, so our family just keeps growing, and you're a part of our family too for being here and helping out. So thank you so much for being with us tonight. I have some other thank yous I need to say before we get started. I need to say thank you to HowlRound TV. They're live streaming us tonight. Nashville Public Television, our roomies, for helping us make that happen. I also want to say thank you to Nashville Arts for some media support that they gave us for this, and a big thank you to the National Endowment for the Arts. We finally started getting funding from them this year, from the NEA. So we're very proud of that. I also, of course, can never stop this section of my little talk without, of course, addressing the person without whom this project would never have happened. She puts her money where her heart is. She believes passionately in the importance of new works. And so a big round of applause and thank you, please, for Martha Ingram. The New Works Project has three parts to it. There's a lab, a fellowship, and this festival. And the lab is something that takes all season long, and I'm actually going to bring up the director of our lab to tell you a little bit about how this project works. So please say hello to our playwright-in-residence, Mr. Nate Eppler.
I'm Nate Eppler. I'm director of the Ingram New Works Lab. Thank you so much for being here tonight. I'm thrilled that you all came out to support this brand new play. Since 2009, the Ingram New Works Project has supported the development of 46 new plays for the stage. This is pretty awesome, right? Each and every single one of them was built right here in Nashville with Nashville artists and in front of Nashville audiences, and all of them have gone on to development and production at theaters across the United States. Each year, we get hundreds of applications from exciting playwrights, and out of them, we pick four playwrights of extraordinary promise. We pick plays that we think we can help, we pick plays that we think our audience will want to see, and we pick playwrights that we really believe in. Each one of these plays comes to us as a pile of pages. It's just an idea. They haven't written any of it yet. And over the year, we give them transformative support. We give them monthly meetings where they get to work on the plays with Nashville artists. We give them access to Nashville Rep staff, and we give them access to the larger Nashville arts community. And then, at the end of the process, we throw a great big festival and invite all of you into the room. When this play came to us, Jonathan said he wanted to write a play about his grandmother's immigration to the United States, and it would be somewhat interactive, and it would definitely have pop culture and superheroes in it. And so we said, yes, absolutely. And so the play you're gonna see tonight is a little less formal than our other readings. The boundary between the audience and the actors is gonna be a little more permeable. Here in our space, it'll be a little bit so. So we're gonna leave the lights on, and there's no intermission. If you feel the need to get up and go to the bathroom or just leave because you don't like it, please do. And we will tell Jonathan that you went to go to the bathroom. After the show, we're gonna have a talk back about the play. And this is the most important part. The same way that we give these plays and these playwrights the opportunity to develop the play, this is the moment that we launch them into their next phase of development. And so we need to hear from you, the audience, because that's what we're about. We take a brand new play and we put it stay with us after the show for a talk back. That's enough for me. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the show.
We see what happened. An immigration play by Jonathan Alexandratos.
Hey there, Nashville. Hey. I'm Jonathan Alexandratos. I'm a playwright based in New York City. It says I've got to engage with you in some banter right here and ask you some questions, but I'm four Ingram New Works playwrights from with Nashville Repertory Theater. We all had to propose a show to the rep as part of our application, and I basically outlined this solo play about my grandmother's heartwarming immigration to the U.S. with my grandfather in 1951, and their romance that bridged an ocean and created a family. I call it We'll See What Happens. You might know how solo plays work, but I play all the parts, and I'm the narrator, but I'll switch into different characters as I need to, okay?
Okay.
Great. So, here we go. The year was 1929. We're in Ithaca, Greece. It's cold and snowy morning in December.
There's no snow there.
And Olga Alexandratos was just born.
That's not my name. Olga Alexandratos is my married name.
It is no snow in Italy. I know born Mary. Ocaccio, Olga Ocaccio, later Alexandratos. You don't even know my name.
Sorry, she wasn't supposed to be here tonight.
Granny, what are you doing here?
Look, I bring food. All these people, they very hungry.
What is that?
Spanakopian. Spinach, cheese, no meat there. Good for everybody. I warm up down the hall.
Did you use the oven?
Oh, I use the oven.
Oh my God, the one thing Nate Eppler told us not to do. He said, you can dynamite a baby in your play, but for the love of God, don't use the oven.
Eat. Mangia.
My grandmother knows that mangia is Italian and that she is Greek. Granny, you are detracting from the authenticity of the evening.
Shut up. You know nothing. Do my drops.
What?
Do my drops.
Your eye drops.
Do my drops.
Maria was going to do your drops.
Maria no come, so I find you.
How did you know where I was?
I Greek woman, I always know.
Granny, I do not have time to do your drops. I have to do my solo play. You know about my solo play? Oh, I told you about my solo play the other day. At the Friends and Families performance, if the show makes it that far.
Kick me out.
Well, I can't just...
No. You don't want me? Kick me out. You kick out all the blind lady who come from the Bronx?
No, of course I...
Do my drops. God knows how long Granny gonna be in this world. How do you want me to be? Blind? I don't want to suffer. Doctors say I have macular
degeneration. Can you just do your drops yourself?
I scared. You do for me.
Okay.
Here. First the orange, then the green, then the other color.
Purple?
Purple. Then last, the blue. I have a whole of rainbow in my eyes.
Jonathan does first the orange.
Good, Matiamo.
Then the green.
What you doing?
You said next.
You don't do now. You're going to make my eyeballs burning.
20 minutes? I don't have 20 minutes. I have to do my solo play. Granny, can I please just do my solo play? These people pay very little, and if they don't get what they want, they're going to be pissed.
Shut up! What do you mean, play? You play when you small. You tell me you play, so I bring your junks with me. But I say, no, can't be play. How you play?
It's a play like theater, not like a play like toys.
Oh, like Phantom in the Opera.
Yes.
Me.
Because you have a wonderful story.
But you know, ask me anything about my life. How you know it's wonderful?
My father told me.
Your father know nothing. What's he tell you?
He told me everything was perfect. He said everything was perfect when my grandfather was alive, and when my grandfather met you, and when my grandfather came to this country, and when my grandfather brought you to this country, that everything was perfect back then, because you were so young, and brave, and perfect, and happy, so I made a play like that.
What kind of shit is this? Nobody perfect, nobody brave, and nobody happy all the time, that's for sure. I tell the truth.
But I know the truth. People to know that that's where our family is coming from, because that's where I come from.
Yes, but why you no ask me?
Granny, this is already so far from what Nashville Rep invited me here to do. It's my job to talk, like the other playwright. They're grannies, let them talk. See, my job is to show how much love this family has, and how love triumphs even through immigration, and how much I love you, and how much I fit into this family.
You love me? You love me, but you no let me say anything.
No one here wants to hear. I didn't mean it like that. I just mean, we like happy stories. Everything else is so unhappy, and you have a happy story, which I can tell in happy English. Will you just please let me tell the happy story?
You no talk to me like this. Like I no know what's happened to me. Like my English no so good. You no even speak one word of Greek. Not like your cousin. She speak beautiful.
I know what this audience wants. I've rehearsed this. Just let me do my job.
I talk my story every day.
To who?
To them.
Granny points to her bag.
A bag?
Look inside.
Jonathan looks in the bag.
Are these my action figures?
I say that. I say, I bring you junks because you say you want to play. Now you tell me you don't want to play, okay. But they know my story better than you. So we talk, you eat spanakopita pita, and do my drops, okay?
I can't believe you saved these action figures. For? Oh, and Captain America. Oh, and Supergirl. Oh, and Black Widow. Oh, whoa.
Jonathan realizes all the action figures are now standing behind him, people-sized, ready to tell Granny's story. They all look almost like their superhero counterparts, except that something is off. Black Widow holds a baby in her arms.
Holy shit sticks! This is way more than my MFA from Queens College prepared me for.
They gonna help me. They gonna help me to talk. You gonna help me to see. They gonna help you to see, Ned.
Granny, I don't understand. Why are my action figures people-sized? Why are they going to talk? And do they know this is a solo play?
Jonathan, Akimu, once upon a time, you used to see Granny every week, you remember? Now, you no come. Now your mommy and daddy no come. Now, whole family think I talk crazy. This, all I have of you, these jumps. So I talk to them, now they talk to you. You father tell you the truth? I don't think so. You know the truth? I don't think so. Not yet. They gonna show you.
Okay, they're gonna show me, but maybe after my show?
Ah, my show, you say? My? What kind of man is this? He say my when he talk about Granny. He tried Granny's story and not let Granny talk. You see what happened? We let the men talk, we let the men talk, we let the men talk. They know nothing. Your grandfather do that.
My grandfather was a great man. He would never do that.
Your grandfather, great man. But no care too much for what others feeling. No care so much for what women feeling. You steal from me just like him.
I care. Of course I care. I'm not like that. I don't want to steal from you.
Then prove it. You gonna trust Granny. Or what? You steal from old lady? No. Now I talk.
Why haven't they said anything yet?
They you junks. But I buy those things. They listen to me. They wait for me to say, okay.
You went to tell my story, tell the story. And these action figures are going to help you?
They gonna help me. They gonna help you. Nah. That's what I want. And my drops. Come on, what else we gonna do?
All right.
The action figures all put on a piece of clothing, becoming a character in this play.
December 11, 1929. I was nothing in 1929. I was born in Ithaca. Look at my mother holding me.
Fuck you, you were born a girl. Yes you were, so daddy left me. Yes he did, now you're gonna grow up fast and get married and be someone else's problem. Yes you will,
Her hands shake as she sings this. It feels like my whole planet is about to explode.
Granny, did you make yourself Supergirl?
Of course, why?
Well, it's just the Supergirl. Thank you.
Son of! I'm old, blind woman, and if I say I look like that, I look like that. Now you sit and eat and listen. I'm sorry, my dear.
Oh, it's okay. Honestly, and I didn't know this then, but If that planet that was my mom's shaking arms did explode right then and there, I don't know that I'd be mad. Would have made things a lot easier. See, in 1929, I was nothing, but 1929, these guys were 20.
We enter Club Itaki. Captain America and Thor.
Hey there, I've got a secret identity. Want to know my real name? It's Dionysius. Dionysius Alexandratus. I'll star spangle your banner.
Hey, I'm Thor. You want to know my secret identity? Well, you have to have sex with me first.
You tried that shit last week. Hey, that's rape.
Yeah, I should say that. Yes, don't worry, I'm here to protect you.
We'd not let anything happen.
Hey, this isn't your scene.
So, what was it you wanted to tell me?
Oh, yeah, dude. Okay, so like, I got a plan.
Oh no.
No, for real this time, bro, just listen. What do you
want? Me in the middle of a Thor sandwich.
Exactly. Great goal. Now, here's how we accomplish that. Tomorrow, we leave for America.
No.
Why not? We're merchant marines. It's what we do. We sail places and tell women we're marine marines, and we never get shot at. It's just... anything, we'll get rich. Like, so rich. Rich like you have no idea.
That's not true.
Of course it's true, man. I researched this.
How?
My cousin has a friend who had a sister who married a guy who went to America and opened a coffee shop, and he said it's the shit.
Look, dude...
What all of a sudden? I've been wearing it on my forehead my entire life.
I thought the A stood for something else.
What are you afraid of? The travel? We go and come back. It's nothing, like merchant marines do.
It's not that.
What then?
It's my mother.
What about her? You hate your mother.
Yeah, but what if distance makes the heart grow fonder or some shit?
Thor, you won't be thinking about your mother when you're knee-deep in pussy. Unless you're into that.
Oh, fuck you.
Look, real talk for a sec. You know me. My mom died. You know how I joined up to support my three sisters. I'm man of the house, bro. But you know what? Here, I don't feel like a man. Why? Because look at the shit that happens here. Yesterday, nothing happened. Day before, nothing happened. Day before that, Stavro died chasing his goat down a hill, and the whole island... Oh, men don't sit around and do nothing. Men make money. Men fuck bitches. Men go to America. Are you scared of being a man?
No.
Bro, we're bros, right? You think I'd let anything happen to you?
Why do you even need me at all?
Because look at all those people who go to America solo. What happens? They get lost. Don't you ever notice that? These people that just go off and you never see them again? And they're just... something. But the two of us... two bros have been going on adventures and being badass warriors since we were little. We ain't gonna get lost. We're gonna fight. We're gonna win.
Win America?
Yes, bro! I know we're gonna be in the soup, but stick with me, okay? I got your back.
Knee deep in pussy?
Knee deep! 34. We're on a list, bro. A ship carrying sugar to New York. Ha! Yes! Save tonight! Tomorrow we'll be gone!
Oh, I am totally gonna use this to get laid!
We hear Springsteen's born in the USA.
Oh, shit, man! I love this song! Yes!
Bro! What does it mean, wound up like a dog that's been beat?
Make a Thor sandwich, which I don't even want to know. And Dionysius Alexandrados partied the night away, getting in one last bump and grind before the big day.
Oh, wait. Granny, no, my grandfather did not talk like that.
Yeah, I did.
How you know?
Well, because that's not what he's supposed to be. He's supposed to be old and loving, like a Werther's Original commercial. but Greek. He never had sex.
Yeah. I did.
He do worse than that.
Ooh, Granny, I am trusting you and my action figures to tell an honest story. So far you've scared me and this audience. Look, they don't want to be scared. They want to be comforted.
They or you? You wanna go back? Go back. You no care about Granny. Go.
The story you told him is not the script
like
I
play
had.
Play with your jobs. Here, take some money and go buy whatever you want.
I don't want to leave. I want a place here.
Then help Granny. That's your job. Your new job. Help Granny. And Granny no forget you. Granny no forget you here. But you have to help Granny, okay?
I've always trusted you.
Then let me show you something.
It's the next morning. Thor has agreed to go along with this plan, even though he's totally not sure what'll happen. He meets up with Dionysius, dragging a...
What the fuck is that, bro?
Suitcase, man. Got some comics, underwear, even made a salad.
Yeah, we're taking exactly none of that, bro.
What? Why?
We are illegal
immigrants, dude. We do not get the right to fucking pack.
We're not illegal immigrants. We're on a list. Why are you so on edge, man?
Well, so, remember how I said we were on a list?
Yeah?
We're not on a list. We're sneaking aboard.
What?
Now, ditch that ball and chain, bro.
Thor gives the suitcase to the audience.
I gotta tell you, bro, for someone who's trusting you, you're making me feel like a fucking chump.
No, it's okay. Look. Look at all the boats. All right? They all go to America. We just have to get on one.
Well, how do we do that?
Watch. Which one of you bitches wants to be in my boat?
No, dude, not cool. They're not gonna go for that shit. Look, hey, we are two poor Greek men who want to escape to America for a better life. You help us, please.
Okay, I gotta step in here because these assholes have no idea what they're doing. I need two volunteers. Really? I'll give you some candy if you help? Yes. And yes. Come on up. You won't be harmed. It's totally safe. 100% safe. All right. So. Two over. Just hold hands or something.
Yay.
Thor?
I mean, thank you.
Mm-hmm. And our heroes are off! Sailing across choppy water, and more choppy water. The ship rocks from side to side, up and down. No food, nothing to drink, no sleep. Christmas comes, but no chance until...
I think we slowed down. We're probably just outside of port.
In America?
Yeah, dude, it's been like 2 months. I think we're here.
Now what?
Now, we begin phase two.
Phase two? What's phase two?
Oh, I didn't tell you about phase two?
No! Dude, 2 fucking months on this bucket and you never mentioned phase two!
Oh, well, it's simple. We go to the back of the boat and we jump off of it before the propellers grind us into hero meat. Oh.
Well, that sounds like a great... What the fucking shit?!
Bro! Seriously, do not puss out on me. Remember what I said. I got you.
You do not got me. Someone who got me would not have me jumping off a ship.
We are so close, dude. So close. And once we swim ashore, we get in touch with Pano, you know, my cousin's friend's sister's husband with the coffee shop, and we good. Come on, we don't have much time.
The pair stands on something, ready to jump into the ocean.
Are we men now?
Fuck being men. Let's be superheroes.
They swim. They make it to America. It's epic. They celebrate with a little happy dance.
We made it!
Of course we made it, bro.
Let's go get drunk.
Let's go get rich.
Let's go fuck some
work.
Serving coffee.
And my cousin's friend's sister's husband.
Pano.
Day after day.
Thor and Captain America work in the restaurant.
Help them.
What? Why?
To imagine that's your life.
Jonathan goes to work in the restaurant.
Excuse for acting like children.
You're acting like children!
No, of course not. But you know words like that, not even one day. See, even a little of daylight.
All right, is this gonna be the whole play? Is this what you're trying to show me?
Okay, imagine 10 years you work this way. Now let me show you me. Let me show you what you...
1940, I was 11.
1940, World War II?
Blackout. Supergirl and Thor hand out flashlights. Jonathan turns his on. Granny tells people where the action is happening and helps them shine their lights on that area. There's an Italian soldier there, played by Captain America. He huddles in a corner.
Ah! Oh, that was the sound of my head hitting a beam in my mom's attic in 1940.
Who's it there?
It's me.
Me, like a German soldier waiting to kill me?
No, me, like Olga Kakiu, the girl who hid you up here.
Ah.
I brought you some food.
I'm too nervous to eat.
Come on. Eating will take you away from this place.
Maybe later.
Supergirl puts the plate next to him.
It's keftedes. It's what you Italians call meatballs. Oh, and I forgot, I have a salad downstairs. If you're like vegetarian or whatever.
Why are you helping me?
Because, what did you ever do? You got sent here, you sat in the town square, you ate our food, you drank our drinks, you paid your bill. You were nice to me.
I was?
The other day, you said, hey, nice dress.
Yes. Sorry, I've had a lot on my mind since hearing the report.
I heard it too.
The sound of a plane flying low overhead.
Is it true?
Well, we were sent here to fight.
You did not fight.
How could we? Fruit on the trees, goats roaming the grass, wine flowing like water. This is not some Warsaw ghetto. This is Itaki. What is there to fight?
Germany seems pretty pissed about that.
Yeah.
Italian soldier eats a meatball.
Do you like it?
Tastes like home. Tell your mother it's very good.
Actually, I made those.
You made these?
I like to experiment. It's like food is an airplane that flies around the world of your mouth and it can take you anywhere.
I suppose that is true.
When you do that, it feels like waves on my skull.
Peaceful?
Yeah.
Italian soldier cleans her ears, old world style, with his finger.
You have heard of many things.
Yeah.
My mother used to clean my ears like this because I was very afraid of thunder. Whenever there was a storm, she would say, come, let me clean the thunder out of your ears. And it was gone. You're like 11, right?
Yeah, no.
I mean, I know it's 1940,
no,
but...
I should
yeah, I mean, this sort of thing.
I should
The lights turn back on. What the fuck are you doing, chickadee?
Mom!
Who the fuck is that?
That's a soldier?
What did I tell you about soldiers in this house?
You actually didn't say either way?
Of course I didn't! Because I didn't think I'd ever have to address the issue!
I'm sorry!
Oh my god. All Greek soldiers need to be out there in case the Germans come up, not up here doing whatever the fuck.
Ma'am, you seem upset, but if I could just add, I'm not the Greek, I'm Italian.
Oh my god, he's fighting for the enemy!
They're not the enemy.
Okay, this house is all I have, and it's not going to be taken from me just because my idiot daughter committed high treason in it. Get out!
If I may, ma'am, present some small token of appreciation for your hospitality.
You want to do something for me?
Yes.
Be not the enemy.
Can you fix the bathroom?
I can fix the bathroom, but not the stand.
You fix the bathroom. You fix the bathroom, you can stay the night. Go. My God! Leave the meatballs.
Italian soldier leaves the meatballs. He becomes Captain America again.
What the fuck were you thinking?
What?
No one comes inside the house, especially not the Italians.
Okay.
God. Go to your room and think of the worst thing I could do to punish you.
Black Widow takes the remainder of the meatballs.
Granny, I never knew you hid an Italian soldier in your attic. That's a... What happened to that guy?
Who knows? He got lost in time, probably. I never see again.
That's too bad.
Why?
Kind of wish that guy was my grandfather.
Oh, screw you!
Adso! Why you say that?
Because he'd probably let me tell the happy story.
He wanted that? Yeah. But who knows? He's still a soldier. He's still in the army. Maybe someone he killed. That's what stories someone else say about him. Who knows? You always want to skip straight to dessert. Even your salad is nice.
Fucking asshole, that guy.
You know why you don't know anything about him? He didn't become anything. He got lost. He never became a man.
Come on, that's probably not true. He probably did fine.
Yeah, well, we're not doing a play called Italian Soldier Politely Refuses to Fuck Supergirl, right?
But that doesn't mean he's not a man.
Why aren't you questioning this, huh? Why'd you just hand the reins over to this woman, huh? Maybe she's bullshitting you.
My grandmother wouldn't do that.
Like, just like your grandfather wouldn't do this?
Granny, where's my attic? Where can you hide me?
Here, Matiomo. You can no touch me.
Oh, you fucking pussy. Do not retreat. Oh, do not go in there with her. You need to learn how to be a man. Your dad tried. I know he did. I taught him. But her, she never learned. She never learned her lesson.
Captain America tries to punch the safe space. He can't. His punch repels back at him.
Oh, that is some bullshit! Only I get this shield! Only I get to do that!
Go scratch your ass! He no hurt you here.
I want the Italian soldier back. I want him to save me.
I know, believe it or not. I actually see a little bit of him in your grandfather.
That guy?
When we first met, you gonna see, okay? But he no hurt you. He no hurt you.
This is just like when we'd play in your basement when I was a kid, and I'd never want to go home because I knew at home...
What? It's the Germans then?
Kind of.
Come, it's time.
Granny takes out the next bottle of eye drops. Jonathan does them.
Can't believe you saw World War II. How awful.
Oh, no. We have nice time. No problems, come to Itaki. We make friends.
Okay, so I apologize to, like, every Jewish person who had to hear that.
Why you apologize? Everything different for everybody.
Yeah, but I think we can agree on the horrors of World War II.
Our war come later, anyway. Let us see what come next.
Granny, can I just... Okay, you said help. I helped. Can I just maybe do one scene my way? Please? We saw one war. You're saying there's another one. Can we just, please?
Matteo Mo, do what you want to, but now you have to ask them.
Oh, this should be rich.
Yeah, let's see what you got. Right.
Fine.
Okay. So like we were just in Greece, and it's 1940. So let's go to America. Let's see what my grandfather's up to, okay? My grandfather gave up his vulgar Greek lifestyle. And he and Thor, using friendship, carve out their slice of the American dream in a coffee shop, save up enough money, bring over my grandmother, who I guess he had been longing for, even though we really didn't get many scenes like that before. Just go with it. And he brings her over, and together they cultivate more happiness, and Thor comes over for casserole on casserole night, and he plays with the happy couple's son, my dad. And,
can I just, like, make a couple of suggestions?
Sure.
That was all bullshit.
Greeks don't have no gay ass casserole night.
Right, yes.
Look, okay, here's the real scene. Captain America glues together a broken cup while Thor beats a coffee maker into submission with his hammer. After some hammering, Captain America drops the broken coffee cup piece.
God damn it!
Come on, coffee maker, make coffee! You have one job!
Will you stop it already? That's coming out of our paycheck.
What paycheck? What is this paycheck? Want to know how much I made over the last decade? Like, a nickel, bro!
Don't say bro. They don't say bro here. You're in a new country. Talk new. Grow up.
Bro? I am going to speak my language. Our language. Because this fucking country took everything else from me.
It gave us everything.
What? What did it give us? A cocksucker Albanian landlord who steals from us? Customers who call us dirty greaseballs? Politicians who ignore our existence?
We just have to work harder.
I'm just telling the truth. Stop lying to yourself.
Go toss your salad, man. We have a customer.
Who?
Him.
Oh. What can I do for you?
Hmm? I'm not, I don't think I... Well, I'm just the playwright of the other show. the one we're apparently not doing. So I don't know anymore. I don't know what you can do for me.
Jonathan, I can move.
Oh no.
Yeah. Do me a favor, help them.
What do I have to do this time?
You're gonna play a man from the government, a man from immigration, a man who's have problems with your grandfather, okay?
But I don't have problems with my grandfather. I have problems with whoever this guy is.
Love you too, son.
Okay, good. Then you're gonna pretend you know talk to your grandfather, okay? You're gonna pretend you talk to your junks, okay? You promise, Granny.
Okay, I know. What do I say?
Here, your lines. I wrote them with superpowers.
Great.
Let's go from, toss your salad. Go toss your salad.
Go toss your salad, man. We have a customer.
Oh, who?
Him.
What can I get for you?
Dionysius, Alexandrados, and Thor. You misspelled Dionysius.
Just roll with it.
Oh, and Alexandrados.
We didn't exactly do a rehearsal.
Jonathan, not your move.
Okay. I need to speak to Dionysius and Thor right away.
Yeah, man, I'm Thor. What's up?
Where's Dionysius?
Dio. What? Never heard of him.
What? Dude, what are you doing?
That sounds like a Greek name, and we don't employ immigrants here. We like our workers like we like our toast. White bread. I am George Smith Jones Washington of any town, USA. What can I do for you?
Jonathan, as the agent, unfolds a wanted poster, puts it next to Captain America's head. It's a wanted poster that clearly shows the Captain America action figure.
Always trying to disguise yourself. Too bad pictures don't lie. You're going, back. I need to interview you first separately. Thor, you go into the kitchen.
Yes!
The police are in there waiting.
Fuck.
I always start with the ones that lie to me. I hate being lied to. Tell me about yourself.
All right. Here's what I know. The truth. The truth is, it's 1940. There's a war going on. You need to look good. You need to find enemy sympathizers. What if I told you, Thor in there loves the Krauts?
Really?
Oh, yeah. Can't stop talking about him. Loves Hitler. Said the other day, do you know who's really got it going on? Hitler. His words, direct quote.
You'd sign a report stating this?
Yeah, yes, in a heartbeat if you let me stay.
The U.S. government loves its informants and rewards them heavily.
Great! Asylum?
I can talk to the powers that be, but first, I need... No.
What?
It says first I need to beat the shit out of you to make me feel like I've taught you a lesson about lying. No.
Oh, come on, do it. I'm an action figure, remember? It won't hurt.
It won't hurt you, but...
What, are you a pussy? You can't do it? Oh, you gonna cry, baby? Gonna cry? You gonna go back to being 5 years old, scared of a little punchy punch every now and... Yeah, do it. Don't stop. Make this look good. You're just playing a part. We all are. It's for the story. It's her story.
It's what Granny wants.
No.
What did this family become after I died?
I won't let the violence in.
The violence? The violence is already here, bro. What play have you been watching? Your little after-school special? There's more fist in the air here than at a hard rock concert on the Jersey Shore. Granny opened this door. You helped. This is what she wants.
This is not what she wants. Granny, I will help you, but I will not do this.
Good, Matthew. Good, good.
Hey, guys. Is it time for my interview?
Oh, I don't think that'll be necessary.
Why? Because he just sold you out, got you deported back to Greece.
Oh. Bro! WTF!
Hey, it's nothing personal, man. I can't get lost out here.
Is that why you brought me here?
I think it's time you come back to Greece. There's more to your story, as we all know. You just don't fit in there. As much as I hate to say this, come on back.
Granny, what does she mean?
You gonna see.
Can I get a boat?
No. You have to swim. No one help him.
Thor slowly makes his way back to Greece. Jonathan is distraught. Supergirl approaches him.
Hey there, Sarapus. You did good out there.
You're supposed to be my granny, right? Just younger?
Yeah.
Could you ever have imagined this?
No way, man. I thought I'd be like the last daughter of Ithaca.
No say too much. Is no ice to eat before someone else get their food.
Is he ready for the main course?
That's, I think so. Anyway, he's here. What we gonna do with it? Speaking of main course, we gonna get there soon. First we play a little history game.
Supergirl and Black Widow take the stage.
Okay, so what you just saw took us up to 1940. 1941, 1942, 1943, 1944, 1945, just speed by. Yeah.
Immigrants generally do the same thing for long stretches of time, so you don't have to worry about missing anything in the life of Dionysius.
But in 1945, something important happened in the U.S. Who knows what it was?
Show of hands, anybody.
Anybody?
Anybody
know
at
what
all.
Happened in 1945? The United States, the
you
country
there,
we're
yes.
in, yes.
Yeah.
World War II, end of World War II. Right. Both of those, right. We'll give points
yes.
to both of those.
Well,
that's
yeah.
it.
We'll
that's
take
it.
It. We'll take it.
Then, 1946, uh-huh. Who knows what happened? What important thing happened in 1946?
46.
Very important. Anyone can answer. I'm just going to say anyone can answer
out.
This question.
Just anything.
The whole audience. Anybody.
Anything at all.
Anybody?
Not a fucking thing. I'm just
okay.
gonna tell
them.
Yeah.
Do you know what? The Greek Civil War begins.
That's fine. Yeah.
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 Who can tell me anything about the Greek Civil War?
No.
All right. Yeah. See, Chickadee, I think this is the problem: is that you're asking these people if they know anything about the Greek Civil War, yet they live in a country that can barely teach them about their own civil war.
Thanks, Mom, but like this audience is pretty smart. I mean, like that guy's wearing slacks. I think they could do it, but well, let's run through it anyway.
Right,
let's run through it anyway, shall we? Okay.
All right. The Greek Civil War.
In 60 seconds or less. So, during World War II, the Greek government got out of Dodge because, well, Nazis.
Duh. And after the war ended, there was a big hole where our country's leadership used to be. That usually just works itself out, though, right?
Wrong! Yeah. A group of communists said they had this war hero with a really long last name who would fill the hole, and the Soviets were all like, awesome, new BFF!
But then the other side, those who believed in a democratic government, put forward a bigger war hero with an even longer last name, and the U.S. was all, we still don't really give a shit, but okay.
So pretty soon the Ruskies stopped returning their Greek commie friends' red phone calls, and democracy it was, for a little while, at least.
That wouldn't happen until 3 years later, in 1949.
And it would cost the lives of 158,000 people and the homes of about a million more.
And they ask me why I drink.
That time, people so scared, more scared than World War II, people go door to door, and they shoot you if you're not communist. They shoot you for that.
The Italian soldier said it was such a beautiful place. How can this happen there?
What? You think war look around and say, oh, this is nice place. Maybe no shoot too much. Jonathan, make your move. War is never do that. War have no reason. It's happened for no reason. It's happened in countries, it's happened in houses, it's happened in the theaters.
Well, fuck that. And when it comes up in America's business, I'll fuck their shit up. I love war. War is awesome. War is awesome when you win. And I win. Not like that little bitch Thor.
So I may be back in Greece, but I can still hear all that smack you're talking about me, asshole. Matter of fact, I hear it every day. In my head, over and over again. So much so that I... fucking... Jonathan, get your ass over here.
Is this part of
Come
the...
on, I'm not gonna touch your balls.
Let him go. This is no big part.
All I need you to do is just stand there and say yes when I punch you in the arm like this.
Ow!
Okay?
Not so hard!
Okay?
Yes.
There we go. I, Thor, do solemnly swear in this year of our Lord, 1946, to pledge my allegiance to the Communist Party. Because fuck America, fuck democracy, and most of all, fuck Dionysius! Do you, as bro-in-chief of the Communist Party, Ithaca chapter, take my sacrifice of mind, body, and labor for the cause?
Yes.
Great! Can I have a gun?
Yes. Where is it?
4 points. Jonathan finds a gun. He looks at it with a where-the-fuck-did-this-come-from expression. Thor takes the gun.
Thanks. Now, a couple more questions. Is your name Jonathan?
Yes.
Do you wear shoes?
All right, this is getting really... Oh, yes, God!
Are you a little bitch?
Jesus, come on!
Go to Itaki and leave him alone. I know that you do that. I saw him a few moves. This is the first time he acted out that part.
Well, that's where it starts, Granny. You let him play a part before you know it, he's living the role.
Oh, you're one to talk.
Oh, we'll see.
All right. Okay, let's settle down, okay? I know there's a war going on, but that doesn't mean we need to tear meat from each other's bones. Dionysius, you actually shouldn't complain. 1946 was a pretty good year for you. War was over in America, and what else?
I got my asylum! I'm legal, baby! The agent finally came through for me. Thanks for playing that guy, Jonathan. I guess America always eventually loves its poor little immigrants fleeing communism. Unless you're Cuban, then you're fucked.
Hey, don't act like I let you in here, okay? You invaded. You forced your way in.
You made the deal.
The agent made the deal.
Yeah, whatever you say. Without that deal, there is no you. You're a fucking sheep farmer in Ithaca. The agent, you, what's the difference? You both took me in, eventually. Every party's my party, bitch.
You're here because Granny wanted you here. I do not accept you in any way. There's no way I came from you. Granny, can we just do your drops? Can we just do the rest of your drops so we can go?
No.
Damn it, I'm not a part of that.
Jonathan, not your move. He hurt you? No move.
They go to a safe space. Jonathan rests his head on Granny's lap and Granny strokes his hair.
Eat. Let the food take you away, little manja.
No, Granny, I can't eat.
Why? You don't feel well?
No, it's just... I don't...
Come on, you eat nothing today.
Granny, I've had enough.
Why?
Because I'm full.
Come on.
No.
It's nice.
Jonathan shoves a piece of food in his mouth.
That's a bravo. You feel better?
Ponder.
We do one bottle of drops, okay?
Which one?
The other color.
Purple?
Annette, put the purple.
Jonathan does the drops.
I get so scared to put my eyes myself.
Why?
I don't know. It's just the feeling.
Well, there's nothing to be scared of. It's medicine.
I know that. I scared of what cure me. I'm crazy for that?
No, not for that.
We wait little more, then we do the last one.
Okay.
Okay. We go now.
The action figures are back to action. Black Widow opens a small package.
Finally, thank God, some real meat.
What have we been eating?
Remember that dog you always liked?
Yeah.
Well, now you'll always be together.
Ew, Mom, that's not true.
Oh, 2 years of war, chickadee, it's 1948 now, everything's true. Cost of bread, insane. Cost of repairing this house, ridiculous. Cost of you, well.
Me?
A girl is supposed to be a 16-year prison sentence, max.
I'm 19?
Exactly my point. The meat is a gift. from Father Stephanopoulos. Why did Father Stephanopoulos send us a gift?
I don't know.
For the wedding!
What wedding?
Congratulations!
Mom, what are you saying?
Well, okay, see, the war is hell. But war really just reminds mommies that they still need their me time. So to fix that, Father Stephanopoulos and I have been sending letters. About you. To men.
To men? What men?
Pretty much all of them.
What did you say?
Well, so my writing isn't great, and Father Stephanopoulos is blind, so they pretty much said...
Free pussy! Plus dowry. Ithaca, Greece. House with the blue door. Come and get her. She is a very nice socket wrench. Last part must be a typo. Whatever. Plus dowry. Dude, rich at last. This'll get my sisters off my back for cash. Hopefully a little extra for myself. Oh, fuck it. Who am I kidding? Hopefully a lot extra. I get money. I get laid. I get a wedding ring, which will undoubtedly attract more chicks. It's the American dream, baby. I just gotta get back to Greece to get it. It's a win-win.
Except for her.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want to have a say in this?
No, now, Jonathan Akimu. Let him go. That's okay.
Yes, Granny.
Oh, that's probably a husband. Who is it?
Ma'am, I'd like to talk to you about our Lord and Savior, the Communist Party.
Oh, Jesus Christ. We already bought some.
Ma'am, that doesn't make any sense.
Go away.
Ah, fuck it.
Thor breaks down the door and enters.
Ma'am, what the hell is wrong with you? Aren't you a patriot? Don't you care about your country's heroes?
I don't get involved in politics.
This isn't politics. This is Greece. This is humanity. Now, you have two choices. Either join us, hand over your land and possibly your daughter, and support the equal distribution of wealth, or die. Whichever.
Leave my family alone.
What family? I see no family. Where is the man of the house? I see two women. Two women are not a family. Two women are just a couple of sad hoes.
Oh, no, you did not.
Black Widow attacks Thor. With her protecting her. Jonathan protects the audience. Black Widow beats Thor within an inch of his life.
Mm-hmm. If I were a man, I'd kill you. But I'm not a man. I'm a woman. And I want you to live the rest of your days telling every man you meet that you got your ass kicked by the Black Widow.
Thor stands up, spits on the floor, grabs his gun, and leaves. He sits somewhere, depressed. Granny gets out from under the table and pulls Supergirl out, too.
He's no hurtles no more.
Mom, why?
Because Greek women don't fight.
Well, Granny, do that again. Do what your mother did. Captain America is your Thor now.
No talk about your grandfather this way.
I'm not. I'm saying Captain America over there. He's spreading lies about you, about our family. He's lying. He's lied before and he'll lie again. He's evil. He'll do anything just to mess up this family.
And why? Why he do that? He's no similar to Thor. Thor a communist. He fight like communists, but your grandfather...
He's not my grandfather.
But you move. I told your junks everything. He doing what I say. Ned. Sometimes they act no good, but why you say evil? They know evil like that bag know evil. It's scary what we put in.
Are you telling me that this is an honest portrayal of my grandfather?
No, not yet. You have whole picture. So no, you see only one part.
Well, a pretty terrible part, a part that my dad never mentioned.
Nah, but you see, no. Why you come to my house? Why you hide in my basement? Why I hide you like I hide her just now? Because you know, you see like I see.
No, I didn't.
Lukey, it's no all bad.
Well, I want it to be like I said it was, like my dad said it was.
How you said?
Yeah, how did you say?
You're just gonna tell me I'm wrong again.
No. I get it now, I get it. Like, when I cook, the food takes me away. And it makes me think, I'm the emperor of ancient China, eating the food of royalty. And not, I might be eating Cocos, the stray Dalmatian I haven't seen in a week because the war is starving my island. So, I get it now. This is like your food. Tell me your food.
different scenes. Stuff like generic beach, generic sunrise, generic boat ride, happiness. But I had a wedding. I had a specific wedding in my play. It went, "Oh, Dionysius, I've been admiring you from a respectable distance. Oh, Granny, I've been admiring you too from a respectable distance. Would you like to sit and drink non-alcoholic coffee with me? Of course I will drink non-alcoholic coffee with you." And then stagehands move on to wedding art while they're drinking their coffee, and we just kind of get that it's after the wedding. And then they kiss, except since it's a solo play, the kiss would also be implied.
That sounds like a really shitty play.
Mom, no, I get it. I wish it were that simple too.
Well, it's not. Cut to a year later, 1949. I was finally about to put the door back up when...
Hey there, citizens. It's marrying season. I got a letter about a year ago. I'm here for the bride and dowry and possibly a socket wrench.
What took you so long?
Oh, well, you know, work was insane. I had to get here from America,
hey,
so...
You live in America.
Oh, yeah, you know, I'm an American, but Greek... Greek too, but I love America, not like those fucking commies. If I were still in the Marines, I'd kick their asses myself.
You were in the Marines?
Oh, well, yes. Yes, I was in the Marines. I was in the Marines. Semper Fi. That's Latin for kick some commie ass.
Oh, I love soldiers.
Yeah, we know, chickadee. Cool your jets. America, huh?
Yeah. Anyone interested?
I'll go.
What?
I'll go.
Look, I don't know. I need her out of the house, but like a few islands over. Yeah, America?
Mom, think about it. You want me out of the house. Why?
Because this country's a shithole and I like to drink alone.
Is America a shithole?
There is a right answer.
Well, I don't know. I never even thought about America.
It is not a shithole. That was the answer we were looking for.
But I mean, you're supposed to take care of me. In my old age, how can you do that from America?
You really want me taking care of you. And look, I mean, there's no one else calling. All the Greek men are either dead or in the process of deading someone else.
I mean, what could I offer an American anyway?
Oh, I'm sure we can cut a deal. I'll settle for 90% of your current wealth, which I'm assuming is massive.
You're welcome to everything my husband left me when he skipped out on us.
Mom, all Dad left was a goat and a bullet to shoot the goat.
Jesus Christ, internalize!
Wait. I'm so sorry. Forgive the wacky question, but are you poor?
No, we are not. What do you need?
What do I need? I need a lot.
What do you need?
I mean, look, I can't be a man if I don't provide for my family. I got three sisters. Their house was destroyed in the war. They've been living with the oldest one's husband, but he's getting kind of fed up. So, I need a house.
Then take it.
Mom, your grandfather built this house.
I know.
Where will you live?
I don't know. Catalonia, my dad's home island, I don't know. I'll disappear.
I'm sorry to hear that. You're welcome to stick it out here another year, but then I'm gonna move my sisters in.
Will you take care of her?
Will she be a good wife to me?
Yes.
Then what do we have to worry about?
Wait, can you at least just ask her if this is what she wants? I mean, there's lots of soldiers, Granny.
It's not the time. You have to trust the parents. You have to honor them. That's the love they say. If you no do that, you no Greek girl. You disappear, they forget you.
But your mom's gonna disappear.
She have to choose herself or me. She choose herself to disappear. That she have to do. If my father there, he choose himself. But my mother have to be mother and father, so she choose.
These are the roles we play, and we play them well. Wife, mother.
Man.
Great, so take her. We'll do the wedding tonight. You can have anything else you find in this house. There's some jewelry in my bedroom. Father Stephanopoulos sent a steak. I'll cook it for you. Pretty sure we can knock this wedding out this afternoon.
Mom, I'll cook the steak.
Oh, no, chickadee. There's no escaping this one.
Yes, there is. Tell my version.
But it's not true.
What is true, huh, anyway?
Exactly. Question her.
No, I'm not questioning Granny. I'm questioning you. Granny's been the only person in my life who has made the truth safe. She's never hurt me for telling the truth, never judged me for it. And she's always been honest with me. But so, like, we have a good track record, right? We can do the best we can, and if that doesn't work, we can just lie a little.
Why can't we just lie?
Yes, yes!
Okay, we make safe the truth because the truth no safe by itself. The truth no always nice. Sometimes the truth dessert, sometimes the truth broccoli. Sometimes the truth bloody steak. But you have to eat all the food.
Nah, you lie, you need to lie, it's survival.
Not like you, my lies don't hurt people.
Except yourself.
What does that mean?
You know, you no speak one word of Greek, not like your cousin. She talk beautiful.
Why do you keep reminding me of that?
He's right. No one word.
All right, so that's it. I can't be honest if I don't speak Greek.
People is on the best move.
Oh, great. Even the action figure speaks Greek now. Thanks, Dad. Thanks for the lesson. Got it. Should have paid more attention in Greek school. Then I'd understand what this fucking action figure is saying, and I'd know all about my roots and shit, and I'd tell it like it is, instead of trying to erase some really fucked up pain. But you know what? I liked watching Home Improvement instead of going to Greek school. Sue me.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
I can't understand you. You can't understand me. What on earth made me think I could do a play about this?
Where's your father?
He's coming next week on Friends and Family Night. I told you.
He not tell me that.
Well, I guess he forgot.
Come on. I don't think so. Now, you know, be honest. And if you know, be honest with me, I know feel good to be honest with you.
Did we show him the wedding?
No. Not yet. That wedding, the one beautiful thing I clocked in my soul forever. He no work to see that. No yet. Maybe he gonna. I do hope so sometime soon.
Granny, I want to see what that was. If it's nice, if it's beautiful, I want to see it.
No, you no ready. We gonna see right after the wedding. Look at what happened. Late at night, my husband go out from the house, drunk. I think so happy. Until he finds...
Captain America stumbles around, laughing, happy, and then he stumbles over a derelict.
Hey, watch it, bro.
Bro? I know that bro voice, bro.
Well, look who it is. Captain America.
Thor, buddy, how you been?
You mean after you sold me out and got me deported? Well, not fucking great.
Dude, look at these clothes. Look at this. What are you wearing? That is some communist shit, man.
Please, which side was I supposed to fight for? The side America was on? No fucking way.
You're a fucking traitor, bro.
Don't get all high and mighty on me, Saint America.
Bro, I'm totally Saint America. Guess what? I got married.
What?
I know, right? Crazy, we're gonna go to America and start a family and be all rich and happy and shit.
That's great.
Bro, could you be a little more happy for me?
Tell me about her.
Oh, she's great. She's got like these tits and this ass, and her mom's kind of a MILF too. Oh, she's like always got, wears this really hot shirt. She's got like an S on it or whatever.
An S? Where are they from?
The island, bro.
Mom's kind of a MILF?
Yeah.
No dad?
Nah, bro skipped out on him. You believe that? Shit's not manly.
Yeah, tell me. This house, blue door, kind of shitty.
Yo, how'd you know? You hit that?
No. That hit me.
What do you mean? Like dominatrix type shit?
Not exactly. A year ago, I was banging down doors for the communists. I banged down that one. The girl hid, but the mom, that bitch fought me.
No.
She fought me. It was epic.
No, it was not epic.
It was.
Bro, I thought we were supposed to have an epic battle. Now I want an epic battle. Who can I epic battle?
I'm sure you'll find someone else.
So what happened?
I was gonna kill her. I was gonna rape her and kill her, just like I'd heard in the army. Stories. Real men getting hard for that shit. But I couldn't. I didn't feel it. And then she kicked the shit out of me.
You got beat up by the Black Widow, bro? That's fucked up, dude. I don't even want an epic battle you now, because you lost to my fucking mother-in-law.
So for the last year, I've been sitting here. Evaporating. Slowly. Disappearing. And someday, I think soon, I'll disappear for good.
Yeah, bro, I can barely even see you.
See my gun?
Yeah, bro.
Take it.
Captain America takes it. He picks it up, plays with it. He likes it.
Nice. Reminds me of my cock.
You can have it. If you do me one favor. One favor. so at least I'll know what kind of man you are.
Yeah, bro, whatever.
Put it in my mouth.
What?
Put it in my mouth, the barrel. Put it in my mouth.
You talking crazy.
Do it.
What's up, man? Why?
Don't ask questions. What, are you afraid of a little blood, or are you not man enough to take out a pussy like me? Come on, a girl kicked my ass. Now you're saying you can't?
Captain America puts the gun in his mouth.
Fuck that shit.
Pull the trigger.
Captain America does. Click. Nothing. A moment. Click. Nothing. Click. Nothing. Captain America takes the gun out of Thor's mouth.
WTF, bro?
It's not even loaded. It was never loaded. They never once gave me bullets.
Then why'd you make me do that?
Because now I know. I know you haven't changed. I know you're exactly the man you used to be. You're still the type who would pull the trigger on a defenseless half-man like myself, and that's good. Because now you're married to a woman you thought was all sweet and virginal and obedient, but now you know where she comes from. You know something about that cunt mother of hers, and you know that somewhere inside of her is the urge to rebel. And you'll always know that you'll have to keep her in line, or else she might just kick your ass. Then you become me, an evaporating man lying in the street waiting for death. So you better keep that bitch wife in line, bro. Because her stock is not to be fucked with.
I'm stronger than you.
Does she know that? Because if she doesn't, she might try something, and you can't have that. Where's your man card then? I hope you were happy during your wedding, during your party. Because Club Itaki is done, bro. That's the last time you'll feel that happiness. Soon, I'll disappear. But when I do, you are going to carry my curse. When I'm gone, you will carry my curse, and just when you feel safe and secure, I'll always be that voice in the back of your head telling you to be a man, telling you to be a teacher, telling you to teach that bitch her lesson.
Go fuck yourself.
Thor disappears. Captain America stumbles off to America. Before reaching America, Jonathan stops him and says,
"Can we just lie a little?"
No, that was your line, asshole.
No. I'm beginning to regret it.
Whatever.
Oh. Granny, how do you know that happened?
Because I'm Greek woman. I always know. I see that face my whole life. That face erased the Italian soldier. That face take over my husband's life. I know.
I didn't know it then, but I did know that Dionysius promised to bring me to America 2 weeks after the wedding. It is now 9 months after the wedding, and I'm pregnant. Spoiler alert, we totally had sex. Deal with it. I better make it to America before this baby happens.
No shit. Traveling with a baby alone? You couldn't pay me enough to do that. What time do you leave tomorrow?
6 a.m.
Boat or plane?
Boat.
Christ, the guy cashes in my jewelry and can't even get you on a plane?
Supergirl lies down uncomfortably.
Who knows?
Here. Here.
Black Widow gives Supergirl a pillow for support. Black Widow looks at Supergirl for a moment.
Thanks.
You look just like I did.
Seen one pregnant chick, seen them all.
That sounds like something I'd say. Don't sound like me, chickadee.
Why?
Well, you can do better.
Sounds strangely like a compliment.
I'm never going to see you again, am I?
I don't know. Mom, can I do this?
Yes. Make it to America? Yes, absolutely.
How can you be so sure?
Look at what you've already done.
What's that?
You lived through two wars. You cooked food for, like, everyone you ever met. You survived being raised by me. You're a fighter.
I learned from the best.
I lost my rhythm. Couple of lucky shots, that's all I got.
Why do Greek women never fight?
Why do Greek women never fight?
You told me that once. Greek women never fight.
Let me tell you a personal story, okay? You deserve to be bored by at least one. When I was a kid, I don't know, let's say 9, I was a dancer. I loved to dance. I'd skip school and just dance in places I thought were ugly, places I thought were beautiful, places that were just places. One day, I was dancing around this big fountain at the center of Kefalonia. I was supposed to be in school. And my father, who was on his way to the post office, saw me. I was mid-saute when I felt my wrist nearly break. And it grew another hand, and that hand was attached to my father, who dragged me home, turned on the stove, and held the hand that was attached to me over the fire long enough for me to smell my fingerprints. Next day, I went to school. I was sad. I didn't say a word. Why? Because in front of me sat a girl who was raped. Behind me was a girl with a black eye, and absent was a girl who no one had seen for days. I was hurt, and I couldn't even talk about my pain, because what was my pain when everyone else had been hurt worse? Why do Greek women not fight? Because some tried, and some lost, and some lost bad. And if they couldn't do it, who are we to think we could?
When I was born, did I cause you pain?
Yes. Yes, I wish there was some way for me to tell you it was the best pain of my life, but it wasn't. I didn't want a girl, and I didn't want you.
So why keep me?
Because providing for you gave me something to think about besides my own pain and loss.
It's not your fault.
What?
It's not your fault. I wish our culture let you have more. Let us have more, but you were abused.
Of course I was abused. And you were abused. We were all abused, Chickadee. But they don't abuse to abuse. They abuse to teach. That's how they teach us, and how they were taught. I learned my lesson.
And what was the lesson?
That you just...
Do you think maybe there never was a lesson, but we have to believe there was, because if there wasn't, then shit, we were just abused.
Look, lesson, no lesson. What exactly do you suggest we do now?
I love you.
You know, that's the first time I've heard those words.
How do you feel?
Your moussaka was very good last night.
Thanks.
You're up early. Get some sleep.
Supergirl starts to immigrate to America.
Baby steps, Supergirl.
Oh, Jesus. You see, yes, I want more scenes like this. This is what I mean.
Oh, yeah, that's love right there. Getting touched on the arm by your mother. Oh, I'm gushing. Come on, bring her to Papa. Oh, no, wait, that came out weird. Bring my bitch to America! Yeah, there we go.
Wait. I'm the one who has to deliver you to this guy?
It's okay.
No, it's not. You just had this beautiful, loving moment, and maybe there could have been more beautiful, loving moments, but now I have to rip you away from that and pull you across an ocean to be with this douche?
I was always going to be here. It's all already happened.
Come here a minute. I gotta teach you little Greek. Come here. You don't want to take her, okay? Come a little bit and learn. In Greek, we have word philotimo. It's no word in English. It means love, but no love. Love that's come from many things. Respect parents, do good, get gifts, give good, cook for family. It's like love that God wanna,
the highest love.
That sounds nice.
Nice. Sound nice. But no one knows what it means. So everyone try to act this way. And no one knows this way supposed to be. So a lot of people try.
And fail.
Nah.
That's depressing.
That's life. Some people, they know. Some people, they don't know. My mother, no, no. Your grandfather, no, no. Your father?
No, no.
That's, I think, so. You know this way. Lismo, no.
No.
Ah, your mommy and daddy should teach you that. Lismo, no. It's mean to forget, but not forget like normal. It's when you forget someone you love, and to be afraid to forget that, we say, when we write in letters in Greek, we say, no forget me. And we use this word because people forget. There's no like forget to watch TV. It's worse than that. Lismano. That's we understand well. That's what we do.
If you want to remember, you should write it down.
That's it. But I know write so good. Who's gonna write?
Oh, God.
Then you know what you have to write.
Yeah.
What?
Philotimo? It's like there was so much to say, so we made up a word, but no one knows how. No one knows what that word means. And now we have to figure it out together.
Together. I trust you.
You know, I never really had a moment like Supergirl where I could say I love you, except to you.
That's, I think, so a place we start. But if you no take me to America, you no bring me there. We no say nothing later on. We never say I love you, because I no know you, and you no know me. That's, I think, so.
I think so, too. If I could go back in time and tell my granny anything, when she was a child, it's that I love her. So I know you don't know what lies ahead, not really, but I want you to know I love you.
I love you too, Montiamo.
Oh man, that's some Marty McFly shit right there.
Supergirl pulls out the pillow that's making her look pregnant. She picks up a bundle that looks like a bundled baby.
When I first come to this country, I know like.
My husband works all day. I'm stuck at home, cooking, taking care of the baby. Spiro, we named him. Dionysius is dad's name, that's the Greek tradition. I don't know anything about Dionysius's dad. I remember less and less of Greece every day. I try to sing Spiro the one song I remember from my mother. Fuck you. You were born a girl. Yes, you were. Yes, you.
But I don't understand what I'm talking about.
I always thought it was just like a traditional Greek rhyme. It didn't mean anything.
Later, my husband say, don't sing like that. That song for girls.
Today, I cook. My cooking doesn't take me anywhere anymore. It just reminds me of stuff I don't have. Salt. Bread. Milk. Bread. Shit. Dionysius loves bread. I have to go to the what is it? The supermarket?
We're in the supermarket. Black Widow gives 4 loaves of bread to 4 different audience members. They hold them. One is Wonder Bread. It doesn't matter what the other 3 are. Thor enters dressed as a supermarket employee.
Can I help you with something?
What?
Can I help you with something?
What?
Can I help you with something?
I can't understand what you're saying.
What's your name?
I can't, wait. Name?
Name.
Olga Alexandrados.
Alexa what?
Alexandrados.
What kind of name is that?
Huh?
I said, what kind of a name is that? You don't sound like you're used to it yet. Just married. You'll never be a good wife if you hang out at the supermarket all day.
I'm a good wife. I can be a good wife. I'm learning how to write my new name.
Oh, you can understand me now.
What are you talking about?
Your man's gonna be home in what? An hour? Imagine if he doesn't have dinner waiting. Greek men don't like that.
I need bread.
Take your pick.
How much is it?
Depends on the brand. That one's 75 cents.
I'll give you 50.
This isn't Greece, chickadee. They don't bargain here. You pay what it costs.
But which one do I choose?
That one's enriched wheat. That one's whole wheat. That one's classic white. That one's classic enriched white wheat. Choose!
But I just want some fucking bread. God damn it, why are you making this so hard?
That's America for you. You have to make a choice. No one's gonna make it for you, especially not me.
Supergirl weighs the different breads, trying to decide, getting more and more frantic with each one.
Breaking down in a fucking supermarket. You're embarrassing yourself. You came all this way just to cry over bread, and you know you'll always be haunted. Haunted by the lost people of home. It's your curse. Even when you're not watched, you're watched. I'm watching you. We're all watching you. Everyone that never landed, that never got remembered, that tried and failed. We're watching to see if you'll be like us. Your husband, your new name. See, there's a man. There's a man who goes to work every day and provides. You know what he'll do? You know what will happen if you can't do your job? You know what Greek men who don't want to be forgotten, who will do anything to be remembered, will do?
Wait, no, I got this. Granny, you always have this one, right? Here you go, Wonder Bread, you like that one. It's always in the house.
Well, is it good?
Well, yeah, well, they're all kind of the same.
Hey, can I help you?
What's he saying?
He asked, Voronova pizza.
Oh,
you remember the bread I buy?
I remember we used to go together to the supermarket.
Jonathan, I don't really know where I've wound up. Okay, I'm kind of all over the place here.
Boronovitzo?
Yes. Yeah, just keep talking, okay? You're doing great. Just keep remembering and say what you remember, just like you remember it. And don't worry about anything, okay?
That scares me.
I know it does. It scares everyone.
I remember that Granny used to watch a lot of I Love Lucy.
Yes! I learned all my English from I Love Lucy.
So I'm at home. I'm watching I Love Lucy with the baby.
She watches I Love Lucy with the baby. Enter Thor and Black Widow, who take on the roles as Ricky and Lucy from I Love Lucy. They act as the couple would on the famous TV show.
Ricky, where are you going?
I'm going to rehearsal, Annie.
Again? You've had rehearsal every day for a week.
I know, but I can't help it.
Wouldn't it be easier to get good musicians?
Please, no discouraging remarks.
Discouraging.
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 Come on, what are you, stupid? Discouraging.
Discouraging. Ricky!
Shut the fuck up, honey. I'm trying to get this immigrant retard to learn a goddamn word of English.
Oh, my God. Hey, you know, screw you, asshole. I kicked your ass once. I can do it again. Chickadee, it's okay. You know plenty of other words. You'll be fine. You did learn plenty of other words, right?
No.
Oh, fuck me.
See? That's what I'm saying. She learns nothing.
Can't you people leave me alone? How are you even here, anyway?
Oh.
We follow you.
The old world.
We never leave.
We never die.
We taunt.
We live in your brain.
We warp and change.
And become everything you don't need.
Everywhere.
All the time.
You're not real.
I don't think you'll ever learn English.
I hate to say it, but I think he's got a point.
Another lost body in another strange country. It's cool. You can join me floating around out here.
And you can join those girls I went to school with who just disappeared.
Wow, this conversation is a bit discouraging. I mean, isn't it?
I'll make it. He'll make it. I left Ithaca. We have to make it.
The ones who leave are never written about.
Not in their old hometowns, anyway.
Greeks. We hold a grudge.
No, no, no. This isn't what I meant when I said about I Love Lucy. Will you leave her alone and go back to being a TV show? Hasn't it been hard enough for her?
Oh, Ricky, please, let me do the commercial.
Oh, no, nothing doing.
Why not?
Look, honey, this is a big deal for me, and I need someone with a lot of experience.
Well, I've had experience.
Granny shuts off the TV.
You gotta make me dinner now. He gonna be home soon.
All I bought was bread.
Captain America comes home.
Where's dinner?
Well, we have leftovers. I saved leftovers, and I have bread.
What?
I made too much last night, so I saved it.
So you mean, I get to come home after a long day serving fucking assholes coffee, only to come home to last night's dinner?
I'm sorry.
Not good enough. What the fuck have you been doing all day?
I was looking after Spiro.
It's hot. The TV's hot when it's been on.
And I watched a little TV.
It's hot. What the hell have you been doing all goddamn day?
I watched some TV. I thought I'd learn English.
Thor enters and watches.
Huh. Why? You gonna be a lawyer?
No, it's
you're not a fucking superhero, okay? You have one job, and that's to be my wife. Got it?
But there's so much
more. What?
There's so much more I can do.
I'll show you what more there is.
Do it.
No, no, stop it. Granny, do something.
It's happened like that.
And it won't happen again. You're not even supposed to be here. You're not even legal.
What did you say?
Captain America runs after him, ready to assault.
Machimo.
Grabs Captain America's shield to defend himself. Captain America batters the shield. Jonathan's close to getting hurt himself. Granny pulls Jonathan into the safe space. Captain America's fists freeze just outside the space, just about to hit Jonathan, but not. All other action besides Granny and Jonathan freezes.
Kill him! Kill him! Why? Why do I always open the door? Why do I have to let the bad guy in? Granny, do something!
Shh! Matthew, no be scared. Your grandfather died already. You know what? What's I gonna do?
But make him stop.
He's your junk.
But they listen to you.
They listen to you.
Not him.
Then you need to make listen. Why? You know important? Let me know. You forget yourself, you want to remember? Write down. You say that. Put down this.
Granny these, points to Captain America's shield.
These two no work for you. Look. Okay. Let me know. Look this book.
Granny takes out an old book from her bag.
I take everywhere this book. Every family in Itaki have small book to put names of family. So here we start, way back, and here end.
Is that your name in Greek?
No, that's my mother's name. That's the only place I have my mother's name. I know there. Why? Because you leave. Because I leave. When you leave, they know right down. Because you disappearing, you leave my know.
I don't think that's right. We should have our own book.
And who's right? Who's put their name there?
My name. Listen to me. I made it up. Okay? My entire solo play. I made it up. I never asked my dad anything. I never asked Granny. I never even Googled. I made it all up. I made it all up because I didn't want you in your story. I didn't want you to have a place here. But here you are. Fists in the air. But you know what? That's okay. Because you fit here. You've always fit here, but so do I. It's not like Thor. It's not like Black Widow. You're in me. So if you hit me right now, you're hitting yourself. And you're hitting my father, and you're hitting Granny, and you're hitting my mother, and you're hitting everyone else in your future. And in your past. Because they're all in me. Me. You don't even know who I am, do you? What's my name?
What's my name?
It's Dionysius. Jonathan. Spiro. Alexandrados. According to Greek tradition, my first name is also your name. So do it. Hit me. Hit yourself if that's what you want. I'm staring you in the goddamn eye and telling you to hit me. I won't do anything. But I'll know what kind of man you are.
Is he ready for dessert?
Nick.
Yes!
The first few bars of Bon Jovi's Bad Medicine starts playing. Supergirl enters happily. It's their wedding night.
Okay, so like, in the back of my mind, whenever I get to talk about our wedding, I always picture doing this dance number to Bon Jovi's Bad Medicine here. But I don't think we have the rights for that, so I'm just gonna use this time to level with you. Now, it might have been the ridiculous amount of ouzo I drunk, but I need you to know this. It's the end of a decade of war. And here I am watching this person, this girl, dance and climb all over this club, and it's like, she's my wife, bro. That's my wife. And see, as a Greek guy, the term doesn't really mean anything, but like, it also kind of does.
Whoa!
See, you shut up and everything. When you're young and a man and in Greece, you shut out every fucking thing. Because if you let it in, it destroys you. It like strangles your heart. So you take all your feelings and you put them on like a boat and you send that boat off into the ocean and you like never see it again. So you know that you can provide. I ain't got time for that boat, man. I've got to make money and provide. Fuck that boat.
Whoa.
But you know what happens when you do that. You struggle, bro. You struggle like fuck. And that wears you down. And then someone like... girl comes into your life, not through romance, fuck that shit, but like through something random. And what's she driving? She's driving that fucking boat. That fucking boat that you sent on the ocean when you were young, and she's all, here you go, here's all your fucking emotions on one fucking boat. So of course you're like, bitch, get away from me. Bitch, get in the kitchen. Bitch, take care of my kids. Because you swore if you ever saw that boat again, you could never be called a man. But look at it. Look at that fucking boat. Swimming circles around me, bro. Swimming absolute fucking circles. You know, in this moment, I see that boat and I see her driving it. And I'm like, a piece of me made it. A piece of me made it all this time. A piece of me made it because she's fucking driving it. How'd she do that?
One more time!
How'd she do that? I don't know if I'll ever see the boat again like I see it right now. But I'm gonna miss the shit out of it. I wouldn't even know what to do with it. With her. I barely even know her. But what I do know is, America better fucking watch out. It has no idea what's headed its way.
That was fun! That was fun! Now, what did you want to tell me at the wedding? What did you want to tell me?
Wasn't important.
Okay, whatever. But, hey! Hey, so I was thinking, okay, look, I know what this is, okay, this is like a survival thing, right? Like, I get to be the last daughter of Ithaca, and you get laid, I know, like, I'm realistic, but, hey, look, what I'm trying to say is, I know you're Marvel and I'm DC, but do you think we could work something out?
You remember that night, Penny?
I do now.
Oh, what you want to tell me?
It was something I couldn't say till 1975.
When you died.
We hear the boot, 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 boot of the club. It slowly slows to become the boom, 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 boom of a heartbeat. It fades, but it's still audible. Captain America puts on a hospital gown. Granny goes to help.
I got this. Come on. I got this. Come on. Every party is my party.
Even if you you have the cancer?
Nothing a cigarette can't cure, babe.
You're gonna die. I see you die over and over. And I cry for that, you know?
Why?
Because my whole world gonna destroy and you give me my family.
You annoy the shit out of me.
This is the love I know.
Well, do you ever think about what will happen after we die?
We go to heaven. It's happened now for you. Maybe next year I see you again.
No, but do you ever think about the stuff we won't get to see? Like, what will people do? Like, will they make a hat that also serves you beer?
I think so, they have that. I see on TV.
No, but you know?
I don't think about that because I do all I want to do here. So now I just enjoy.
You did?
Of course. You suffer a lot, Daddy.
Someone else has always suffered more.
Nah, but it's important. You got to be honest about yourself. You got to say the truth.
But how can you? How can you watch all this shit break and not break yourself?
Because I have break. I do that in this exact moment. I do that when you die, like you're gonna die now. And the only way I don't do more is I speak every day the story, and it's okay. That's okay, that's okay.
I'm proud of you.
Dionysius died.
You had two moments. In almost 25 years, you had two moments. Against all that abuse.
Yeah.
And you tell that story.
Now you're gonna do better. Your grandfather and your father.
Nah.
Okay. But when we hide from him, there's so much Granny I see in you. And so much I see you I see in Granny. So even with your father, who is your grandfather almost, I save you because I dare. I dare in you. And your grandfather in you. And in you, it's okay. So I save you.
And I'll save you. Captain America, Steve Rogers, an immigrant through time.
And I'll save you, Supergirl. Kara Zor-El, an immigrant from Krypton.
And I'll save you, Thor Odin's son, an immigrant from Asgard.
And I'll save you, Black Widow, Natasha Romanoff, an immigrant from Russia.
And look what's stamped on the bottom of our boots.
Made in China.
And I'll save you, Jonathan Alexandrados, an immigrant through abuse. Granny Moo, my whole life I felt like we couldn't talk. We couldn't talk the same story, but please let me try. In your language. All my life, I've been phobos menace about looking in the mirror because I see Thanos. I see the telos, the end. I remember when I was 12, we put on capes made of phylas and became heroes. We looked like Superman, and I thought that was it, that we were Ischiros. And so when my dad, when he'd be like, when he'd act like, when he'd steepo me, I thought, I'm the last son of Krypton, and I'll die alone. Because I'd never wish that on anyone else. But Granny, I want Irene. I want a happy Melantokios. Because I have that, maybe if I have that, I can have more than my dreams. Maybe, but then I'm so scared. I'll steeple my children like my dad did to me and my grandfather did to you. I'm so scared
that I wrote a theatro about a perfect Zoe where everyone was happy all the time because I'm not a writer. I'm not a singrafias. I'm a people pleaser, but I can't please my pateras and I can't please my papu because I can't put my emotions on the boat with my pateras and my papu's emotions. I feel them. Even though I try not to. Granny, I'm tromokratemenos. You didn't understand a word of that, did you?
Matthew Moore, I know you before you born. I know you before you born. We have language before you have mouth. When you parents, when they think I'm crazy, when they think I'm talk crazy, when they no let you come over no more, I talk our language. I talk our language to them. You junks.
What? You know they're not drunks. That one sells for like $50 loose on eBay.
Of course they junks. What you do? You put it in box and you no think about. You have to use, and they help you a lot. Now you take them. They help you write new story. And you help me to see you.
I'm right here.
My drops. We have last one, the blue.
Oh.
Aha! Ah, I see now. Now I see. I see Itaki. Look, it snowed there.
I thought you said it didn't snow there.
It snow now. I always wanna. I see snow first time in America. I always wish I have snow in Itaki. And now look, oh, snow, come. Oh. We play now, we build snowmen, we make angels, come. Where come from this snow, who knows? It look like no belong, but it's what we wanted for a long time. Oh, so who thinks that? Belong, no belong. We happy, it makes us happy. It's belong, we play now. We come a long way. I feel like little girl I wish I was. So nice this snow, so nice and Itaki. You believe that?
A distant bouzouki plays.
Ah, you hear that?
No.
It becomes a distant boot of the club.
You hear that?
That I can hear.
It becomes Agolemeno, a Greek rap song by Sotiri featuring Makroyani, available on YouTube.
I love this song. Come, we dance together in the snow.
Granny starts dancing the traditional Greek circle dance known as the Kalamantianos. She pulls in Jonathan. Jonathan pulls in Captain America. Captain America pulls in Supergirl. Supergirl pulls in Black Widow. Black Widow pulls in Thor. Thor pulls in the audience. Everyone is dancing and dancing. End of play.
Please, a round of applause for Jonathan Alexandrados, our playwright. Now, that's definitely enough attention for Jonathan. For the next little while, Jonathan's going to be dead, right? I'd like to see playwright for the next few minutes, and I promise I'll bring him up here, and he'll be able to answer some of your questions. So, I want to know, what's on your mind right now? When we talk about these plays in the room, the first thing we talk about are the ideas or images in the play that are jumping out right at us. Right at this moment, what's on the top of your head? Anybody?
I
want to
call my grandmother.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. It's so sweet. I can't think of an awful lot of plays that are about leaping over the generation closest to us, to our grandparents, particularly one with this kind of story. What else? What else are we thinking about?
The
circle of life, that circle dance, the yeah. Greek dance that ends up in a circle and hands held, and the, just the ring of how it goes from, it goes in a circle versus, I don't know.
Yeah,
something
no,
about
I mean,
this play
yeah.
That goes in a circle.
Yeah. What else?
The story about the classmates.
Oh, yeah. The story that Black Widow tells about the other girl.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's so much in that one character, right? One of the moments that always jumps out at me in this play, and did again tonight, is the moment where Supergirl tells her mother she loves her. And Black Widow says, "Your moussaka was good last night," right? I don't know what that says about me, but that moment just screams to me, right? Like, I know years of their relationship, I know how hard it is right in that moment, and it seems so hard-earned by that point in the play, right? What else? What are other moments like that, or big images that jump out? Yeah.
The idea of putting all the emotions on the boat and not allowing them near, not dealing with them, and I think that ties in with how hard it is to say I love you, or your moussakas.
Yeah. You know, and he's talking about something really specific, right? He's talking about not being allowed to say those things. The play talks about toxic masculinity over and over again, right? And that doesn't mean, like, you know, men are bad. That's about the way that masculinity, like, is bad for the men themselves, you know? And Captain America is certainly talking about not being able to do this or connect in this way and push it away on that boat. That is a powerful moment. Over here. Nope. Yep.
I was actually reaching for the same thing that I found it really moving to see a macho man sort of stand very still and talk very openly and honestly exactly how he feels.
Yeah. What else? Other moments? Yeah.
And the voices that'll be there to tell you how you're doing all the time.
The voices that'll be there to tell you how you're doing? Yeah. Yeah. Isn't that true? Yeah. You know, we were talking in the last talkback about the way that the old country is characterized in this play. That I know this is certainly true, not for my parents, but for the generation before them, right? I mean, like, that they really carried so much of their past was right there in the room. You know, so much more so. So, did we learn anything new from this play? Did we learn about, all right, who knew about the Greek Civil War? Honestly. Right, did we learn stuff about the Greek Civil War? Well, we knew that it happened. We knew that there was a Greek Civil War, right? Did anybody feel like this play was a different immigration story than you've seen before?
Yeah.
Yeah? How so? I know, it sounded like she said it. Anybody want to talk about the ways they thought it was different? I mean, you know, there's a lot of the same. Yeah.
Just felt like I've heard the good and the bad immigration stories, but I felt like this was so true, and that you know, the kind of thing of like the idea of an arranged marriage, and idea this is like the way out, and how it just focused so heavily on that, and I think that you know, it kind of spoke to our kind of ability to. You know, take the bad and make it good, because even though Grandma had, you know, never, you know, Granny had never, only had a couple of really good moments throughout, out of that, she was always so optimistic and so good, because, you know, it kind of speaks to human resilience and what immigration is about, getting away from, you know, the hell that you live in for the possibility of something greater.
Yeah, well said. Yeah?
Yeah, it reminds me, you think just two generations ago, and my grandparents immigrated here, too. And she says, "I'll never see you again, probably." And that's probably true. And this was just two generations ago. It was like 200 years ago when you moved, you know, from the East Coast to the Middle West, you know, of our country. It's like, "I'll never see you again." And our generation, we can pop in, we can Skype you, we can, you know.
Yeah.
We never have to deal with any of that.
Oh, yeah.
We're letting go like that. We never have to deal
with
that.
Oh, it's very different when Black Widow says, "I was thinking maybe you'd move a couple of islands over, not all the way, you know, to America." Yeah, that's it's hugely different. I mean, I don't know. I mean, the kind of resilience that Granny shows in this, it's totally rare. It's completely unexpected now, you know, that that she would survive that, let alone thrive in the way that she obviously did. Right? What else? Other stuff that jumping out about the play? Yeah.
I enjoyed, again, talking about the resilience, but the way that the Granny is portrayed, she has the right to celebrate her life. We all have, and I think that's part of being wise.
and to celebrate the good and the bad, which as you are older and wiser, you realize you celebrate all of that. She has no regret.
Yeah.
And I feel like the writer wants to dramatize a life or project struggle onto something, and the granny demands that right to celebrate her life.
Yeah. Yeah, warts and all, right?
Yeah.
Listen,
yeah.
This is true, right? Like, it wasn't until I was much older that my grandparents started telling me the stories about the real stuff, right? You know, before that it was like, oh, it was great. It was black and white. There was the Depression. I'm sure that everything was lovely. And they had a very chaste romance, you know? This is not true, right? And I mean, so much of this play is about, like, how scary it is to ask those questions and how easily it is to just imagine that it was, like, chaste and black and white and... you know, and nothing like as messy and complicated as life really is right now. There's something so powerful about a play in which a grandmother comes in and kicks it over right at the very beginning, right?
Yes.
I just feel like right from the get-go, we're on her side, yeah? I mean, we just, yeah.
Well, she fed us spanakopita.
Also, she fed us. We wanted to shake Jonathan and tell him the real story, right?
Yeah.
Smart.
She also is referred to as talking crazy all the time, and she talks to his toys and tells his toys the truth about her life.
Yeah.
Which I was like, that breaks my heart. That's who she has to talk to?
That's the audience.
Yeah, who she's telling the truth to.
Yeah.
His jokes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was kind of interesting, too. They talk about the year 1929, while Anne Frank was born in 1929, mm-hmm. and Jackie Kennedy. And you think of things, my mom was born in 1929. And you think of where you're born dictates so much of what direction your life went.
Very true.
Just all these famous people.
Very true. Yeah. Do you have a comment?
Yes, Andrew Kramer.
our friend Andrew live tweeting us from the future of the internet.
He says, I think what's different about this immigration story for him is the play is really about inheriting a destructive sort of history. Not only are you embarking on an immigrant's journey fleeing social or cultural upheaval, but you're also embarking on a journey of inherited abuse because of those things, and there's something very painful about experiencing abuse within your ancestral lines.
Yeah, well said.
I think the thing I thought was particularly interesting is it seems that there's a switch that you usually think about or read about abused people trying to disappear. Mm-hmm. And in this instance, you note that the abusers are fed this message about you have to abuse in order to not disappear.
Yeah.
And I thought that was a really interesting, it just seems different from what you typically read about abuse.
Yeah, I would agree with you. There's a couple of things in there that are very, the notion of abuse as a lesson teaching tool, right? And then the people that are abused question whether or not there's something valid to it. And then the reasons that, I mean, we actually get to see that, right? Thor stands next to Captain America and says, like, you're going to have to teach her a lesson or she's going to, you know, race you. I mean, that's very powerful and unusual.
A quick comment, and that was, it was two-thirds of the way through the play, and it struck me, I thought, this playwright really is a great actor. And it was like, well, did he get his grandmother to do it with him? And so I read the program, and was like, oh, shit.
Well, you want to meet the real guy? Let's
figure
it out. Ladies and gentlemen, John.
I really am going to start sending Jess to work.
Yeah.
And just do all, you know.
Well, you spent the day with your stage grandmother, right?
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
So talk to us about, so I think we have some idea of where the play came from. I mean, honestly, your life, right? But talk a little bit about what compels you to write this play now. Why now?
Yeah, so why now? Well, I think that, so I just finished a play that is sort of very much about my own experiences and my own sort of life, and I wanted a better understanding of why I am who I am. So I started to look into my family's history, specifically my grandmother's life, who I'm very, very close with. And the more I started talking to her, the more I really desired a bridge between her and me. And I felt like we needed one, because she speaks Greek and I speak comic book. So I was like, how do we meet? And so I started to write this play, and was lucky enough that you guys let me come here and write it some more. And what I realized as I was writing it is that we don't need a bridge. We're in each other. And the same way you are inside of your family members. There are no separate bodies in love. Love is the synergy. It's the coming together. And so I love that through this process, I was able to start building a bridge, then just destroy the bridge and realize that we're just together. We're together right now. And that's why now.
How'd it go?
How did it go?
Yeah.
The process of writing it?
Yeah.
It was great. I mean, it was, you know, some parts of it were like considering your heart to be an atomic bomb and deciding to set it off within you because it destroys you so much to think about people that you love being hurt and people that you're related to hurting, meaning physically abusing. So that was painful to go through that, but cathartic. Because I feel like my story is a very specific Greek story, Greek-American story, but it's also not. I mean, there are themes in there that I think that a lot of survivors and a lot of just other people can hopefully connect with, and I'm always kind of seeking that, you know, the point where you go so specific into your own self that it just becomes incredibly general, and it becomes applicable to everybody. And I'd imagine that if we all spent the night together and just talked about it, we'd all probably find we're pretty close to one another when you get right down to it. And I was on that journey, and I think I got there.
Yeah, I think you got there. Yeah. So what questions do we have for Jonathan?
Has your grandmother seen this?
Well, this is kind of the first time we've taken it out of the barn, so she hasn't seen it yet, but hopefully, you know, we'll get to... And get to do that.
Did this actually start as a one-man show that you performed and then altered it into a play?
No. it was always kind of meant to be like that because it kind of also helped me to step back from what I really wanted. And I think, though it didn't start as a one-man show, I think it did start as sort of the focus being on the self, on the me, and the process of the learning process here is that it's not about me, it's about her. And how do I show that process?
As you were peeling all of this back, was there ever a point where you wanted to give it up?
Yeah. Yeah, sure, absolutely.
Why did you keep going? What kept you going?
That's a great question. There were moments specifically as I was about two-thirds of the way into the writing process that I absolutely felt every time I opened up this document on my computer, I felt the physical pain inside my stomach because I was like, I cannot look at these words anymore. And the second I started to think like that, we would usually talk. and that was wonderful. But so this man is a good guy and was very helpful in those moments. But also, in terms of keeping going, as soon as you get there, you start to see something a little deeper. And as soon as you see that, you're encouraged to keep going. And then you start to say things like, well, okay, but what happens if I move this scene over here? What does that do to what I'm seeing now? Oh, it changes it radically. Oh, this is exciting. Let me experiment with that. So in that moment of doubt, you find something new.
I knew
a bit of the harsher reality. I do think, though, when I started writing it, the first draft kind of did have a very happy ending. It kind of ended with just the birth of my dad in America, and it's like, yay, everybody's good and happy. But then my grandmother said something to me, which is in the play, and it was just one line. And she said, one day we were just sitting talking, and she said, you know, when I first come to this country, I don't like Oh, that's aggressive. Well, that's odd. Why is that? And then she would say all these reasons. I'm like, but of course that's true. I mean, you were kind of left alone there and to figure out all of these things, like what a supermarket is and, you know, what the price of bread is and, you know, all these things that we think of as just such minor inconveniences, if they're inconveniences at all. But to a new immigrant, they are huge problems, and they were in her case. And on top of that, you can't go home and talk to your husband about these problems in a real deep emotional way. I can't imagine that. So that's where that ending kind of took a dive for me. I was like, well, I've got to show it. I've got to show it the way it is for her. Anything else? Yeah.
Did she ever go back to Greece?
Yeah, so she tends to go actually once, she tries to go once a year over the summer usually. Actually does love it there very much. She goes back to.
Have you gone with it?
I have, yeah. I have done that once in my life, and I'd like to do it again. I think I was probably too young to appreciate it, so I think I'd like to do it again, just if nothing else for that. I mean, this has given me such a new appreciation for all of that culture and all of that that's in me and that's in her. So yes, I'd love to go again. But yeah, she goes. She goes a lot.
Did she see your mom again?
In reality, yes, she did. Actually, Black Widow in this story is more of a composite of other women that are in my family, because I also wanted to kind of show their reality. So I kind of put them into Black Widow, and sort of imagine like what it would be like if they were interacting with Rand. Yeah.
You had a question?
Yeah. There's something else. Oh.
Just a kind of a personal family question.
Great.
Are you, as far as your grandma and yours relationship, are you closer to your grandma than you'd say that you are to other family members?
Yeah. I mean, my grandfather died before I was born, and so I never got to know him. And I think the consequence of that was that I got originally a very, very clean version of who he was. And the more I sort of dug around, the more I was like, it's not that he was clean or dirty or whatever. He was a human, you know, he was a human being. And he made mistakes. And he also made successes, you know. And he's as complicated as probably any of us, perhaps more so due to the abuse. I think there are probably some of us here that would say, oh, that's too far. I wouldn't do that. I hope we all say that. But you know, I started to think about that, and all through my life, my granny has been the person in my family who's been acted upon, meaning things have been done to her, and I felt it was deeply unfair that she never really got to be, I think, her fully, you know, and I wish I could have known that person. You know, I think that to some extent I do, but I often wonder if she were born now, you know, what would have happened. I wonder about that a lot.
It's incredible. Yeah.
You know,
it's interesting because I'm closest to my grandma.
Really? Grandmas are special, right?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, she kind of helped save my life. It's so crazy. You know,
yeah.
She was the only one that understood.
Isn't that great? I mean, it's so true. I used to go up there once a week in high school because in high school I felt like such an outcast. You know, I barely had any friends. And, you know, anything. And whenever I go to her house, she had cable TV, awesome food, and she was awesome. She would, like, you know, seriously, she would curse. She told me this one story one day of her friend who literally dropped dead on the side of the highway after he got out of his car, and she was laughing. She was laughing about it. And I'm just like, how can you, who are you? How can you do this? And she's just like, yeah, he just dropped dead. And I'm like, say that again. She's great. She's an amazing person.
We have time for just one more question for Jonathan. Well, I'll ask. What is next for the play?
That's up to you.
What do you want to see with this play next?
I want to see it staged in a place where we can all kind of sit on sofas, eat Greek food, go pee whenever we need to pee, listen to these people do their amazing work, and just kind of hang out and have a cathartic time together. talk about abuse and talk about what's been done to us and connect with one another and turn to someone next to you in the audience and say, I was hurt and I'm owning my story in this way. Because I feel as though there are people here who might be able to do that, and theater can do that, I think. So, you know, that's what I want. I want to talk about it.
Yeah, we're going to help it get there, man.
Great.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jonathan Alexander. Saturday night, our festival closes with Thrill Day by Helen Banner, live and live streaming. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for supporting me tonight.